Phil here from Cobourg Tae Kwon Do, and welcome to my weekly, bi-weekly vlog on martial arts, Taekwondo, and Cobourg Tae Kwon Do, and anything in general. I basically discuss topics that people should know or need to know about martial arts, mainly Taekwondo, and how we kind of do stuff here at Cobourg Tae Kwon Do. Today, I want to discuss about black belt testing or black belt grades or promoting the black belt. So basically, you are a higher level black belt, or sorry, higher level color belt, or you're essentially about entering the black belt cycle for testing here for your black belt. So there's many different ways that different schools test black belts. There's a way that we do it, and I'll explain that in a few minutes. There's a couple other ways that people do it too. Some schools, they just randomly give people black belts when they go through the color belt system. They think that they've done what they need to do to earn their black belt. Some schools will do formal testing, and so what they'll do is they'll bring a panel of black belts in from their school, or a lot of cases from middle school, and they might do a couple hour grading. So you'll have to come up in front of a panel of judges and do certain requirements to achieve to earn your black belt. I know at my master's school in Toronto, DeSanto's Martial Art, Veronica DeSanto, we do 40 hour black belt grading, which is called Power Weekend, where we go in on a Friday night, and we come home on Sunday, late Sunday morning, almost Sunday afternoon, and we do about 40 hours of just anything and everything that we have to do. Plus, Black Belt Photography Ceremony, Team Building Weekend, Midterm, Black Belt Cycle, whatnot. There's some schools that do all day Black Belt grades, such as what we do. Some schools do like couple hour grading, like I mentioned earlier. Some do half day grading. There's so many different ways that you can do a black belt grading. So how we do our black belt grading here, or testing and self promotion for the black belt, is every September, about mid-September, we sit down with all what we call black belt candidates. So these are higher up color belts and they're eligible for black belt testing in June of the following year, so 9 months away, roughly, as well as the black belt that have already gone through testing, the black belt, first degree, second degree, third degree, etc. We sit everybody down, all the parents and guardians as well, if they're like junior members, and we basically have about a half an hour, 45 minutes, and we discuss all the requirements of this particular year's black belt cycle. Each year is slightly different, because we're always progressing our system. We're always, making changes, always improving upon what we know. Just make things better. We're always evolving, so that's why we do a meeting every year. And we basically sit down everybody, we discuss everything, make sure everybody understands the requirements. And then what we do is we hand out mentors for the black belt candidates. So we'll take the higher black belt that we have in our second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth degree black belt that we have here, and we will sign them black belt candidates. So we might have seven or eight mentors every cycle, and each mentor might have three, four, five black belt candidates. So over the 9 months, these mentors will look after and help these black belt candidates, help with their requirement, make sure they're staying up to date with your training, help them with anything that they need, just give them advice, just looking after them, make sure, they can, get your black belt grade. So, basically, from mid-September till mid-June, they do 9 months of training. So, they have certain physical fitness requirements that they have to achieve. They have their physical Taekwondo requirements that they have to achieve, certain techniques, physical techniques. They have a few different projects that they have to work on, that these projects are to help develop themselves as a person. We have a team building and midterm about halfway through the cycle, so that we test them on the knowledge that they have up to this point, make sure, you know, they're getting the knowledge that they need. As well as we do a team building day with them, where all the black belt kids, even the mentor, get to know everybody. So they learn how to work as a team. So when they get to the black belt testing weekend, they can work as a well-oiled machine, communicate efficiently, and make grading that much more efficient and more fun. Now, like I said, they train for 9 months. Then we have what we call black belt testing weekend. Basically, they come in on a Saturday morning for 10-hour grading, and we cover everything. Pattern, block, kick, punch, punches, striking, self-defense, mittwork, power kicking, different forms of sparring, different self-defense scenarios, weapons training. We bring in an instructor from Metal Martial Arts School to work with them as well. We do board breaking. We cover a lot in the 10 hours. And then on the following day, we have a black belt ceremony. And during that ceremony, they perform for about an hour and a half on different aspects of their curriculum to all their family members and friends and, you know, the locals around here. But before they do the ceremony, we spent about 5 or 6 hours or so, 7 hours, working on rehearsal, make sure that we have everything really good looking. We're performing, right? So we want to make this a really good show. We want to make the black belt weekend, the black belt graduation ceremony a big deal, and we want to make sure everybody's looking the best that they can and all that stuff. We put a lot of work into the ceremony, with about 7 or 8 hours of rehearsal, and then about an hour and a half ceremony. And the ceremony, again, we go, you know, we show off different aspects of the curriculum. We have some fun with it. We hand out some awards from the grading. Sometimes we have the Cobourg Tae Kwon Do Hall of Fame awards handed out as well to high-ranking black belts that have really influenced Cobourg Tae Kwon Do. Yeah, so we spend the whole weekend together at the end, mid-June. And after all that, the students earn their black belt, their probationary or apprentice black belt, or their full black belt, which is a first degree black belt. So you're not a full black belt until you get your first degree, then second degree, third degree, etc. So that's kind of a little bit of how we do black belt testing here at Cobourg Tae Kwon Do. We take it very seriously, but at the same time, we encourage our students to have fun with it, and we teach them that it's not so much about the physical belt itself, but it's about the journey and what that journey has done for you. So the journey really starts when you first start as a white belt to the point where you're a black belt candidate. And then the second part of your journey as a black belt candidate up to come to your black belt test and becoming earning your black belt. And then the journey will continue from there as you climb up the ranks. And every journey is always different. Each person's journey is always different. Each person has different strengths, different weaknesses. And each time somebody goes for a higher level black belt, they tend to focus on different things. Some people will focus on, let's say, their sparring. And they want to work on their sparring more. Some people work more on their form. Some people work more on their breaking. Some more on their self-defense. You know, we all have areas in our martial arts that we excel at, and then we have other areas in our martial art that we know we need to improve upon. And that's part of the journey as well, as acknowledging what we're good at and what we need to improve upon, and taking the time and focus to improve upon what we need to improve upon, as well as continue to develop the strength that we have. Because it's really hard to be perfectly valid in all aspects of our martial arts training, but you definitely want to have elements where you excel further than other people, and you definitely want to look at the stuff that you're not as good at, which still should be at a high level, and you want to take that to a higher level. So, you know, that's just some of the stuff that we do here at the Cobourg Tae Kwon Do as far as the black belt training cycle, black belt promotion. Again, different schools do different things. We find that, you know, our black belt weekend of 10 hours training plus the ceremony and rehearsal seems to be about the happy medium. Like I said, I've gone through the 40 hours training and all the stuff that involves that. I've been involved with the couple hours training, and I find that the 10 hours training seems to be just about perfect. Obviously, there's no such thing as a perfect belt system or a perfect grading system or experiences, but it seems to work for us, and the students and black belt and instructors and the mentor, we all seem to really enjoy the process. We all really seem to enjoy working with each other and encouraging each other to progress. And, you know, we're really here for each other. The ones that carry on, we really do become a black belt family. You know, that may seem like a little bit of a cliche, but when you go through the black belt cycle, you go through the black belt testing, it changes you and it changes your bond with everybody. It makes your bond a lot stronger, and that's part of it too, right? It's the go through something that you develop these lifelong friends, and these lifelong friends, you'll always have black belt training together. That's something that most of the population will never experience, or they can never understand because they haven't gone through it. I think I've talked enough for today. I hope I've answered a few of your questions about the black belt cycle and how we do black belt testing here.